Okay, we're here for Downtown Brockton Holiday Parade 2015. John with me, John Marion and Paul Marion. John, parade's about to kick off. Weather's not going to keep people away, is it?
You know what? It's a pretty good turnout for a rainy day. You know, it's our 125th anniversary with James Edgar. But you know something? We can't do anything about the rain. But there's quite a few people out here, and it's great.
Rain is flurries in another temperature.
Hey, I remember it colder than this. This isn't bad.
Happy holidays,
the
everybody.
The headsets are on, just so you guys know. We can't really hear each other unless we talk louder. And I can hear you. And here come the Brockton Police Motorcycle Unit that came in under Mayor Carpenter.
I want to thank his administration for really supporting these holiday events this year. Bill Carpenter has stepped up. There's new decorations downtown, and it's just a great thing. Here comes Mr. Edgar right here.
This is Brockton's finest, Brockton Police Department. Honor Guard.
I want to thank the Brockton Police Department, okay, for everything that they've done. They've secured the streets for us once again. Now, Bill McGauley, we got to say something about him. Summerfest, Bill does so much for everybody in Brockton. He is our Good Samaritan James Edgar recipient this year.
Number three is, the parade marshal. What's that, that's
James
a Camaro?
Edgar. Copeland Toyota.
Okay, let's see. The banners are in the wind, so it's hard to see it.
Oh, this is the Brockton Youth Soccer Team.
Okay, there we go.
Yeah, and Brockton Youth Soccer, I believe, won the state sectionals. Is that right?
Well, I'm looking at the numbers, and that says number four is the people that are number four.
Oh, the folks that went with Bill McGauley.
Yep, exactly.
That. The rain has clouded us up a little bit.
We've got those balloon, guys keep getting in the way. They're going to get in our shot.
Right.
Okay, the elected officials, we just saw a glimpse of them. And if we can take a look at them again, they're all marching by. I'd like to see the elected officials so I can name them, please. Okay, there we go. I see State Senator Michael Brady, Mayor Bill Carpenter, Shayna Barnes, Claire Cronin, State Representative, Paul Studensky, Shirley Asak, I don't know if I see
Councilor
Jay Stewart. I see Councilor Cruz, Councilor Sullivan, all of Brockton's elected officials, Brent Gormley, who's an incoming school committee member, and kind of hard to see the whole crowd there. Greg Hanley, Plymouth County Commissioner, Tim Sullivan, and Balloon Guy's going to get in our way again. There you go.
Billy!
Thanks,
John Buckley,
official city council.
Good
Michelle,
job.
Thank you very much. Michael, Claire,
Kathy,
thank you.
Kathy
thank
Smith,
you.
Tom Minicello.
Thank you so much for your support.
And right behind you got the Brockton Fire Pipes and Drums, which is an outstanding unit. They do a great job. Brockton Youth Council on the float from Lynch's. Lynch's supports the parade every year. They do a great job. Here come the pipes and drums, and there's Archie Gormley. Archie Gormley with his kilt. I love it.
Looks like he dyed his hair.
There you go.
Archie.
And you have the fire department, color guard and honor guard. Behind the band.
You know, as they're warming up, I just want to say that we've had more people in this parade than ever this year, and it's raining out, so.
Thank you. come all the fire trucks that all the kids love. We have a phenomenal Brockton Fire Department.
So I just want to say, as the fire trucks are going on, that Selena Rosa has been awarded by Chief Williams. She got the Young Hero Award. And Selena woke up her family in the night when there was a fire in her house and literally saved her family. And it was unbelievable what she did. There's a whole letter that was written here that honors her. But she went in, she let her great-grandmother know what was going on. She saw flames, family was sleeping, and she raced to the bedroom to wake up her family. And the fire department has awarded her, and this is an outstanding citizen, Selena Rosa.
Sure is. Now check out the vehicle you got over there.
It's the Ghostbusters ambulance.
A Brewster Ambulance, which is the new ambulance company for the City of Champions. I'm trying to find out if Larry Curtis is driving that.
Well, while we're watching all the ambulances go by, I just want to say thank you to the committee that's been working since August on this parade. But more importantly, I just want to let folks that are watching know that this parade is a community parade, and it speaks of the communal feeling that we all have at Brockton here, coming together, celebrating the holidays. And coming out on a day like today, you can see some of the raindrops still from the new light poles that we have here. But look, there's people that are still five or six deep, and I just want to say that that's what a community is all about. The weather's terrible. People come out. They want to celebrate their city, as we see.
Okay. There's Brockton BEMA, Emergency Brockton Management. Emergency Management Agency, led by Steve Hook, who is always there for this community. Great guy, and I'm a proud member of the CERT team.
I want to say thank you personally to Steve Hook. He really took care of our walkie-talkie communications this year, and as well as bringing in some volunteers.
He also gave us the generator that we're powering the truck with, so we're very happy about that. This
Worcester
is one of my favorites. It's
the Worcester
Sound and Lights, exactly.
You know, we have these guys coming back every year. I think, you know, music, obviously, guys, Paul. You know, without music, you can't have a parade.
Absolutely. We got a lot of music coming up. We got a lot of bands.
These guys are true and blue. They come down no matter what.
That would be, I think, the Massasoit. No, I don't believe so. That would be the Massasoit Honor Guard, I think.
Yeah, I think so. Massasoit Police Honor Guard. I just want to say hello to President Wall at Massasoit. We're working on a college collaborative to get here in downtown Brockton. I know Massasoit is one of the colleges they're talking about, along with Bridgewater State and UMass Boston. As you can see down here, the buildings are looking better. The streetscape is looking cleaner. You know, Rob May has introduced, along with Mayor Bill Carpenter, a brand new plan for the center of the city, talking about how the center is the core. And there's more and more investment, upwards of $180 million worth of investment in downtown Brockton. So it'd be nice if that college came. We have more people living down here now. It's a lot different than when we started in 91, isn't it, Mike?
Oh, absolutely. The new Enterprise Center looks great, and the Enzo Flats and Stadium Lofts, and just more to come. John, I want to brush up on your Spanish. Can you say that?
Hola, los Estados Unidos de Brockton.
Latinos Unidos de Brockton.
So this group here is a young group of Latinos that wanted to come out and celebrate their community. And show you the diversity. As you know, the community is full of cultural... cultural treasure. right?
Exactly.
I mean, we've got a lot of culture here, and the Latinos wanted to come out and represent their section of the community, and I think we've said it how many times now, we welcome everybody to this parade.
Absolutely.
This is a community parade.
Just look at all the flags flying proudly in front of City Hall. There's a seems to be a flag day for every single group and culture in the city.
Yeah, I don't know if you and, can...
Ramon Sepulveda, I can say that name. Ramon's been active in this community for years.
Yeah, and they were very happy about it. They brought people in from New York on this.
They got Carmen Miranda there.
Huh?
They got Carmen Miranda there.
Carmen Miranda came to the parade.
Oh, there you go. And there's photographer Mark Vasconcelos. Did I say that right?
Yes.
He is a photographer extraordinaire for the Enterprise. Now look at we're going to see this float coming up.
Well, as we're watching the float, I'd just like to say thank you to Terry Edwards and T.L. Edwards. For always being a big sponsor to our parade. Thanks, Terry. Thank you, T.L. Edwards. That's a great float. That float came all the way from New York. I was talking to Ramon. There he is.
They flew that sod in from Hawaii to dress that the side skirts of that float up.
Really? Yeah, they flew that sod in from Hawaii. Is that amazing? Or from South America, Paul. Which one was it? I don't know.
Aiello's on the float, if I'm not mistaken. Felicita.
Hi, Maria. Now, if that doesn't look fun, I don't know what does.
We have the Cosmo Legion Band, who's always in this parade every year. They do a great job. Ed Myers, who's the conductor. I want to give a nice shout out to City Councilor at Large Moses Rodriguez, who always helps us get everybody to stop right in front of us and play the music.
Always.
Number 20 is Troop 80650 from the Cub Scouts.
Yeah, we'd like to thank Ann Silva for putting this troop together and coming
to
the
parade. I see the Masons, some of the Masons from the 17th Masonic District. That's another one I could march in if I had time. I see Brockton Adelte Health. Is Brockton Adelte Health over at 794 North Main Street, I believe? A little out of order, but that's okay.
Well, that's what you expect. The rain's going to mess it up a little bit. Who cares?
Hey, we've had different weather before, John. This is
never stop Santa Claus.
No, you're
today's
right.
It's kind of tough for Frosty. They were just playing Frosty the Snowman over there.
It's got there's a chill in the air.
Remember that day? Remember that year with 0 degrees?
Oh, absolutely.
With a snowstorm?
Sure was. Okay, now here's the 17th Masonic District. Jimmy Sarantopoulos. I think Adam Mitchell I see in the crowd.
Brother Jim!
Brother there we Jimmy. Go.
Merry Christmas!
Brother hey, guys.
How are you? Merry Christmas. Thanks for coming.
Oh, there's George... George Hebert.
It's a wonderful summer day. It's great. It's great.
Hey, George, how
are
you?
Speed.
And the 17th District has a float behind them.
The two Christmas trees right there, the camera's kind of dwarfing, but those trees are as big as the Rockefeller Center tree. It's the angle, Mark, that cable.
Absolutely.
That's a great float. Now, this is our Santa Hat Challenge float, sponsored by Signature Healthcare. Signature Healthcare has been with us now almost 10 years, sponsoring the Santa Hat Challenge. And this year, we wanted to break the world record, and, well, we just might break the world record, but look at that float. It's beautiful.
It sure is. Who's on the floor?
Well, I can't tell.
We got a boxer up front. Let's take a look at the boat and see if we can see who's on it.
The Enterprise, one of our corporate sponsors. We want to thank them.
KO's on the float.
Oh, KO's on the float.
Oh, there you go.
Is that KO?
Yeah.
I think we broke the record. There must be 9,000 people with Santa hats on that float, the way it looks.
There you go.
Right
KO
there,
with
there
an umbrella.
Huh?
KO with an umbrella. I love it.
KO with an umbrella.
Okay, and we have EOMS Recycling.
Lou Tarantino has been a great supporter of the DBA in all the activities that we do. Lou is obviously the CEO of EOMS Recycling, very generous to the city, and he's a character walking the street.
That's Oscar the Grouch.
Oscar
sure
the Grouch. I thought this was supposed to be, well, there's a happy face right there. Right?
SpongeBob.
I wonder if they'll get into a little skirmish. One's a little grouchy, one's a little happy.
Nobody could be grouchy today. Not on parade day. TV.
Dry as could be, right underneath the new canopy, underneath the new truck from Cable.
Paul's behind the monitor. But he's got the best hat in the house.
That's right.
We love that hat. We look forward to it every year.
There it is. There it is. Man, Lou, in the Christmas spirit, painted his truck red and green. How do you beat that?
He's got a tree on the front, too. If you water that tree, it'll grow taller than the rock.
Well, no, but the rain today, that started out as a little sprout earlier in the day. Look how much it's growing.
There you go. Oscar's passing out candy. I hear music coming out.
105.7. Well, they're coming up.
WROR, great radio station.
Now, see, it's just amazing. Look, you can see all the people that are still here. Okay, come out for this event. Of course, like I told you, it was the 125th anniversary of James Edgar becoming America's first department store Santa. So I can understand why everybody would come out. Oh, it is Frosty. We can't see him in the monitor, though.
I hear Spanish music.
Look at the size of that Santa hat.
Okay. League of United Latin American Citizens.
Okay. This is Jose and... Oh, this is
that gingerbread house is made with 400 pounds of gingerbread.
And Melissa cooked the gingerbread, okay? So Jose and Melissa always do a wonderful floor. They're on my committee, okay? And 400 pounds?
400 pounds of gingerbread.
But, Mark, I don't know if you saw it. That was the largest Santa hat, okay, ever to be made on the front of that gingerbread. Right there, see it? There's Melissa right up there. Hi, Melissa. The League of United Latin Americans. Always festive, always festive. Look at that. They're having a party over their house later on, too. I'm just going to take the truck right in, back it in.
There's some motorcycles behind them.
Old Colony YMCA right here. Look at this, all crayons and coloring books.
Old Colony YMCA is a big part of Brockton. Downtown, youth division.
Vinny Materano does a fantastic job at that Y. Look, we have presents. It says Happy Holidays.
The years.
You know, the years.
That they were formed, 1896, 1897, 1967. Big part of downtown Brockton.
Big I can't thank them enough. They do a lot for the
young. Another gingerbread house.
Another gingerbread. Well, that's about 200 pounds. You can see the difference. Is that right, Paul? There's only 200 pounds of gingerbread in that house?
250.
250. 250. Okay. See, look at all the time it takes to put these together. I mean, I got to give them a lot of credit. I really hope that you folks at home really, that you understand how much time it takes to do this. Come out here and parade in March.
Colony-wide bus.
Yeah, it's amazing how they dress that flatbed to look like a bus. I can't believe it.
What is this next group?
Oh, so I want to say thank you to Miss Teen United States, Andrea Gibbo. She's from Brockton. I met her when she was at Brockton High. This young woman is a shining star for the city, an example for our children here. I get to spend some time with her. Of course, I worked with her when she was at Brockton High. She was vice president of student council. And folks, if you're at home and you have children, this woman has worked very hard since she was a young child, okay, to represent not only herself but her community and her culture. And now she's Miss Teen United States. Great example. Walked around today, talked to everybody in the parade. Actually, I'm going to tell you a true story. Gave up being at the Macy's Parade, and that's not an exaggeration to
me. We
have
the Abington High Band, which kind of went by, and they're going to stop in front of us, take a look and listen to Abington High.
Partners.
Take a look at the folks on there.
Marlene Amadei has worked tremendously hard on our committee. And if you notice, there's a candy cane portal on that float. We'll talk about that a little later.
As we look by us real quick.
Well, yes, it's a...
Marlene was helping earlier in the parade. There's the Hancock School Huskies.
I want to thank Steve Shaw. Steve Shaw never says no to be involved in a community event. The Hancock School is where all my children went. And they have a very strong... pack over there, and look, actually the whole school is on that float right now. I can't believe it. I mean, I don't know how Steve does it, but the whole school. Steve, thank you very much. What's it, like 600 at that school?
There you go. 1963. I was there shortly thereafter that.
I was at Ellis Prep.
There's Mary Walden walking through. She's a parade volunteer.
Mary is one of our lot captains, and Mary has come out every year to help us out. Mary, thank you so much.
Thank you, Mary.
Thank you. That was great with the Boys and Girls Club right there. We want to thank Everett's Auto before you mention all this stuff, Mark. Everett's Auto and Lynch's Towing for donating all the flatbeds.
Nope, that's not the Army National Guard. That's Jim's Mass Cruisers.
Right there, National Guard.
Jim's Mass Cruisers is the organization.
See the Army National Guard right there?
Oh, that is Army National Guard.
See that one right there?
Okay,
you know where that came from?
Where?
That came. They brought that back from Fallujah. Now they're going back.
There you go. Okay, now we got Jim's Mass Cruisers. Switch the chart there.
The Army National Guard wanted to be in Jim's Mass Cruisers.
There you go. Exactly. Look at those cars. Oh, I think this is the one with the smoke coming out of the back. As long as there's not fire, I just want to... remember our good friend John Burke. He was a parade chair for years. Loved this parade. I miss him at all the parades, the Veterans, the Memorial Day.
I'm really glad you brought him up, Mark, because John was, you know something? We needed John's rosary bead because the whole time that John was in charge of the parade,
had
rain.
You're right. You're 100% right. We're going to have to ask one of his sons to carry on the tradition.
We got a burgundy Mustang coming up here. Oh, there's a couple floats here coming by.
More Lynches. And there's some international flags on there. Cape Verdean flag.
Oh, that's
Brazilian
the Cape Verdean. Yeah, that might
is
be
the
Cape Verdean
Association.
Yeah,
number 48 is Cape Verdean Association. You definitely want to see that. Float. tarp over them in the back. We know a few people from that organization.
Yeah, I want to thank
Andrade, Moses Rodriguez, Joe Miranda, Mateo.
Yeah, and I want to thank Monica Tavares. Monica works at Harbor One Bank. And, you know, they brought the group out today. It was raining out. The kids were putting the floor together. Andrea went over and took a picture with them. They were so happy. And, you know, we really appreciate them coming
out. Christmas Carol at Massasoit. That's going on right now.
Right. And the reason why the flatbed is empty is because they're rehearsing. So that's why you got to get over there and you got to see him tonight and tomorrow night. I want to thank Craig O'Connor for being Mr. James Edgar last night at the at an evening with James Edgar. Please go visit A Christmas Carol at Massasoit.
And this is the JM Pet Resort.
Yeah, I want to thank Jenny Mather. Jenny's been working on this float for the past 4 weeks. She's been so supportive of the whole Santa Hat Challenge. She runs a wonderful, wonderful organization. She also has the Blue Dog Shelter. It's a wonderful organization that she has, but the pet resort is a great place to bring your pets, and Jenny is just a great supporter. And there she is right there in the Dalmatian outfit. You can't see it. She just went by. And just loves the whole idea of this community. Thank you, Jenny.
You had the BCA North Main Street Veterinary Center. There's another shot of one of the pet resort vehicles that's over on Pearl Street.
Yes.
We're on the west side.
Yes, and the Blue Dog Shelter does just a great job, you know, with healing dogs that are in bad shape. She's got such a great
dog, too. Yes. All sorts of services. So please, what do we have coming up? I'm trying to read it through the monitor.
Looks like 53.
Little Free Library. That's going to be Lynn Smith's.
Oh, that's Lynn Smith.
Neighborhood Park Association.
You know, Lynn has been a tremendous supporter of the parade, the Downtown Brockton Association. She put up all these little libraries, these little wooden libraries where you can put a book in. And
Family Center, Michelle Sellers over the sign.
Yeah, yeah.
They have one of the little three libraries over there, one at the Boys and Girls Club, one downtown, one at the Frederick Douglass Garden, all over the place.
All over the place. You know, it's a great concept. You know, you put a book in, right? Somebody gets the book, then you read the book, you put it back. More communal stuff, Paul.
Got to get them all engaged.
You got to get them all engaged.
Got the East Bridgewater Junior Senior High Marching Band.
Oh, this is the Family Center. Did we talk about this? That
we did.
The size of, okay, the camera doesn't get the size of that house that just went by. That's as big as City Hall.
I see the East Bridgewater Band coming up. Hopefully stop.
It's nice to see the surrounding towns come in and participate in the city's event. This is East Bridgewater, right?
Yep.
Sound good? East Bridgewater is going to the Super Bowl next week. Congratulations to them for getting there. Congratulations to them.
Talk about the football team.
Here we go.
The football team just won the state.
Super Bowl's next
Hashtag USA Christmas Town. Cowboy out. covered wagon that we saw earlier, Mark, was in all of the John Wayne movies.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Somersault Gymnastics Center. Where are they from, John?
They are from, this is Tom Fontecchio and Melinda Small from Stoughton. All right? Santa stars, each of us will be holding or wearing a star with a word of encouragement inside. Somersault Gymnastics is located in Stoughton, Massachusetts. Thank you for coming out. These are the Cub Scouts.
Cub Scouts behind
Jack him. Sherman, yep. Marching group, this is a combination. Christmas decorated tree and other decorated Cubs to parade.
Whoa.
And of course, they're nicely sheltered on
undercover, yep.
Yes, yes.
Nice flag.
Yes.
American flag and the Cub Scout flag.
Here goes Mike Damiano, dressed up as Mike Damiano.
We have number more Pac 2000 Cub Scouts with their Cub Master, some of the parents. Waving to the crowd.
Yeah.
Michael Darsh. He's very dedicated to the Cub Scouts. Had a tour at the studio recently.
This is Island 4 Navy Seabees. Navy Seabees is a naval construction battalion established on January 5th, 1942. The world-renowned Seabees have distinguished themselves a half a century of service in construction and combat. They are still building all over the world.
And right behind them, a few people from the Wheels of Time Car Club. I think my good friend and fellow school committee member Joe Dutcher probably is in one of those vehicles, if I'm not mistaken. Hey, Merry Christmas.
You know, as you're watching all the cars from our era, basically.
Yeah.
Especially that one. That was for my, it's for my era. The 30s. And you can see, like, in the background, the new candy canes.
Here's
that
Joe.
Are on.
There's Joe Dutcher.
Oh,
I knew
Joe,
he was
right
going to be there.
You can see the new candy canes that we have down here for decorations, but also City Hall Plaza has been newly decorated. It's absolutely phenomenal. If you're listening now, you should come down to downtown in an evening, okay, and just enjoy the serenity at City Hall Plaza with the white snowflakes and the new lights,
really nice.
Brand new trees. It's really great, really great.
Wheels of Time, they do cruise nights in the summer, different locations. Sometimes they're over at Southeastern Beach. Sometimes they're Raynham Taunton Park. Maybe we should get them downtown, John. What do you think?
Wheels of Time?
Wheels of Time.
Maybe we should.
Used to be cruising the drag back in the day.
I know. Here's my car. I used to cruise with that car. I don't know how they got my car. Mine was white.
Joe Dutcher comes to the school committee meeting in a different car every time. Except when it's bad weather out, the nice ones stay home.
Well, he's here today.
He sure is. Nice job, guys. Now that one's from the. That's a set. The neck. It's gone. One of them's 1970s. I can tell. It's a Buick Regal. Kennedy School Pack is coming up next. Kennedy School, heart and soul of that school. There's Principal Rogan right in the front, leading the troops.
He is about as gung-ho as you could get. We also went and visited him when I was walking around with Andrea. And you know what? Just like Steve, Brian is always in. And he's got a great group over there. And his students are always involved. Once again, I don't know how he got the whole school on his float, but he did it. Oh, we want to say this is Caitlin, okay? And Caitlin is riding in David Texera's car. And Caitlin is a young Cape Verdean girl that is also trying out for Miss Teen USA.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. Pedro Chandra knows the family, and she came so that she could be a part of this wonderful event today.
Here's the folks from the Kennedy School.
So Diana Papote, I hope I said that name right, is the organizer for the pack. And you need more women, more people, more families involved. Look at that. I mean, they were working on those presents since last year, okay? And that just says what they feel about their community. Well, there is 600 people on that float.
There you go. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays!
And you got Self-Help Head Start right behind them.
You can see the self-help bus, self-help.
Red, white, and blue celebrating 50 years of Head Start in the Brockton community. Well, they do a great job. Early childhood education alongside one of our Head Start school buses, which might be coming up.
Fuel assistance, all sorts of programs. Whoops, hang on a second.
Well, I mean, Paul, listen, you know, for the type of days, you still have a lot of people that have stayed.
So you know what happened, I think, is, you know, everybody just waited to the last minute to show up because they didn't need to stand outside waiting. They came, and now the streets are filled. It's a good crowd.
Oh, the Brockton Raiders football and cheer.
Yeah, Brockton Raiders are here.
There's the Head Start bus.
Yep.
I hear a band coming up, so.
So, as they walk by, they want to promote the sport of football and cheerleading in the city of Brockton. But more importantly, we want to reach out to some of the at-risk children in the city that may not be able to get off the couch.
Merry Christmas!
It's a great community outreach.
Trinity Catholic. Stop, we'll give him a listen. Absolutely.
We had the symphony at the War Memorial last night. Let me tell you something. We got some game here. Mutual Bank has a float this year. We want to thank Susan Fernandez.
And Edgar Park.
Okay. I went down to the Stacey Adams Building the other night. The Edgar Neighborhood Association of Brockton Arts, Heidi Danielson. They're doing a great job down there. I went down to the building. It's a collaboration of two nonprofits working together with a developer to enhance light neighborhoods and to turn the abandoned factory into a cornerstone business.
It's West Bridgewater.
High school has a new high school. The band is stepping it up. Sound great, Paul.
It's good. Great drums.
Almost sounded like a Brockton band there for a minute.
Yeah, sure. Brand new high school. This new high school is going up all around Brockton. Holbrook's building one, Stoughton just approved one, and Abington. We got a great high school.
Thank you. guy. We see in the monitor here the James Edgar Award. The Good Samaritan Hospital sponsors our James Edgar Award every year. And Bill McGauley is the winner. But I must say that the winner of the James Edgar Essay Contest, okay, and I'm going to have to go into the book here to find this, all right, the winner is Rachel Malafront. She wrote a great article, a great paper about how James Edgar inspired her. And we want to thank her and congratulate her for doing that. Also on this float, we will have the winner of the Harbor One art contest winner, which is Olivia Hawes. Okay.
It's a beautiful shot of the float.
Yes. And
nice
so
float.
We want to thank Good Samaritan for sponsoring the essay contest. And the Edgar Award goes to Bill McGauley, who's done a tremendous amount for the Brockton youth, and also Harbor One for our cover contest in art. This is what this parade's about, bringing the community together, but attaching education, art, literacy, music, the whole thing.
Education, industry, and progress. That's Brockton's motto. There's Brockton Area Transit.
I want to thank Ray LeDoux for everything he's done. This year we had advertisements on the buses. Ray was generous enough to help us with that. I want to also thank Ron Farino at Sign Design, who's done a tremendous amount of work for us.
Is the Brockton Rotary Club coming up behind them?
You're a Rotarian, Mark?
Absolutely. I see
Dan Trout, Brent Warren. Trout. Merry Christmas, boys.
Dan president, Trout, past president.
Also of Mutual Bank, but I want to thank Cal Bourne and Jason Bourne. This is a great antique truck that we have here. This is fantastic. Just
reminds me of Green Acres.
Followed up behind him
is Green Acres truck, you're right.
Distinguished Young Women Scholarship, Leadership, and Talent.
Yep, yep. Miss Teen USA, 75. Oh, no, I'm sorry.
Oh, we got a big float coming up here, John. Number 82.
Number 82. Jesus.
Living Word Church.
Oh, Living Word. So listen, last year Living Word did a great job up at their church on West Chestnut Street, okay? And Pastor Flaherty and Laurie, they put this wonderful winter wonderland. And look, they brought it here. See, they take this whole float, and then they put it on the grounds of the church, okay? And you can walk within this winter wonderland that they've done. Now, it's going to be every Sunday from 9:30 to 11:30.
Wow, it's snowing.
So that's Living Word.
You got snow.
It's amazing. Well, they take that whole float, and then they put it right on the grounds, and you're able to walk through it. It's that. What's on that float is almost 2 acres.
Here we go. Is this another float behind it? Living Word Church.
This could be Love Alliance.
Yeah, I think so. 83.
Yeah. And
125 years of movies is the theme of their float.
Wow, that's phenomenal. I mean, so we're going to see, you know, like The Wizard of Oz. And, what are we going to see? I don't know. Frozen. Oh, wait a minute. Star Wars is coming.
Star Wars is coming up.
Louis and Janice LeBue, Love Alliance. So we got the Grinch,
Rocky.
By the way, we got to go see. I don't know if you saw the
Creed movie.
Creed.
Good.
It's the newest Rocky movie. I think they have 50 of them now.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
You see that?
Okay. Boy. Judges have a hard time this year.
Well,
I'll tell you.
And you know what? We have the judges here that are doing the on-site judging. And then, once again, you can get on your Twitter account, USA Christmastown, okay? Hashtag USA Christmastown, and tweet hashtag whoever it is that you want, whether you want Love Alliance Church or whether you want the Brockton High Cheerleaders or whether you want, you know, whoever you want, you know? I mean, you can hashtag Mark Lippin.
This is our ROTC. From Brockton High, the boxer, junior ROTC. Look at that impressive group of young men and women.
Yeah, and you know what? Your son was in ROTC.
He was,
okay.
Yep.
It's a great program.
Megan Henningsen, Ray Henningsen's daughter.
So we're looking at the boxer cheerleaders, right? Yep. And, you know, this is what community's all about, you know? You love to see your children, you know, interacting in all these different things that high school has to offer, right? Sports, right? Art, music, ROTC.
Champion everything.
Champion everything. Look, I explained it the other day. you have, you know, the city hall all involved. You have the school department all involved, right? You have children and families all involved, right? That's what your community's all about.
Sure is.
Well, Colonel Clark, he's phenomenal. I've spoken to him so many times. He's stepped up that particular organization. We had a little void in there.
Right.
Colonel Clark's in there.
But he stayed strong despite that.
He's full steam ahead.
These kids are amazing kids. And if you wave at them, they can't wave back. They might give you a little wink in the eye or something, but they stay in formation. They do exactly what they're supposed to do, how they're told. You see them, they're like ambassadors at parent-teacher conferences up there. And good students.
Right, opening doors, right, telling you where to go. I mean, I've been going up to the high school for 56 years now, and I still don't know how to get around. Inadvertently, I have an ROTC person bringing me around, like a, you know, like an old band.
Now, we hear a band in the background, and it's got to be our world-famous Brockton High School marching band under the direction of Vinny McGreen.
And you know something? We wouldn't be here right now if Vinny hadn't signed on 24 years ago, back in 1991, to commit. Okay, and he called me today and he goes, what are we going to do? And I said, full steam ahead. He goes, I'm all in.
Absolutely. And I just want to remember our good friend, Bob Ferrante, who passed this year, who was the heart and soul of that band as well. And he instructed a lot of children at Brockton High School. I'm very sorry we lost him. So we're thinking of him in great.
Bobby, wonderful man. Went too soon, too quick. He's too young. And did a lot for this program. We miss you, Bob.
So this is a special moment for me. This is my daughter's senior year, and she's playing clarinet in the marching band. This is her last holiday parade.
It's always a big, sweet thing. You know, I remember when my daughter was there. Now Thomas. Yeah, this is last year we're going to be experiencing children in this. Rudolph, you can see in the background, was going to go to Macy's, but you know what? Because of what you're going to see as a float that was built by Southeastern Regional for Santa, from now and ever, right?
We're proud of our students from Southeastern Regional. That story in the paper the other day was amazing about what they did to transform something into something fantastic. Here's the band. We're going to stop and listen. I think they're going to stop them right in front of our truck.
That's good stuff, guys.
Unbelievable stuff. You know, as you see Santa coming, of course, the long bond between James Edgar and First Department Store Santa, the whole legacy of why Brockton is so special to Santa, and of course, he starts everything off here in Brockton, Massachusetts.
Absolutely.
And we have our committee, all right, pulling Rudolph.
Good job, everybody.
We have Nikki B. James.
There's Santa right there.
We have Pam Gurley. All right, we have Frank Gurley, we have Chris Koska, we have everybody from our parade right there, pulling Rudolph.
There's Santa.
That's pulling
Santa.
The
man of the hour.
Thank you.
There he is.
And there's the man himself. Last night when we did an evening with James Edgar, Santa came in at the end and was a big ball. And here's this wonderful float. I want to thank Roy Blanchard, who retired. Dana Batchelder, Joe Mott, who is sick, and I hope you get better. Ronald Cassette, okay.
Merry
Bill
Christmas.
Collins, Bob Ross, and Shirley Ezrins, okay. These are all teachers that partook in this, okay. 18 months. Art, body shop, wood shop.
Collision repair, everybody.
It was unbelievable, and that's a gift, okay, to Brockton. We want everybody to always, from Southeastern Regional, to be a part of this wonderful, wonderful float that was given to the city of Brockton.
And I promised a couple of people at the beginning of the broadcast a shout out to Heidi and Nicholas Ammon from Mama Diane. She came up to the booth and asked me. So I said, sure.
Why not?
Just met her, wanted to share the Christmas spirit.
And thank you to Bradford Steel for giving us that steel. But look, this is what a community's about. Oh, and the post office is collecting letters. I just want to say, you know, it's unbelievable that they're even doing this. Okay, you can go to the post office. Okay, Linda Kennedy, who's the assistant postmaster there, is collecting letters that will actually go to the North Pole. So really, we want to thank this type of involvement, whether it's the post office now who's involved, whether it's Southeastern Regional, who worked 18 months, all right? Two different classes, class of 2014 and 15, I believe.
And we're getting the wrap sign, so we're going to leave this coverage and go more Christmastown USA later on and tomorrow.
We got tomorrow, right? We got Santa Claus. But look, I want to thank everybody. Please, give me 1 second. Thank you to the mayor's office, to city council, school committee. Okay, thank you for Brockton Cable, the Enterprise. All right, all our media sponsors. Thank you to the community of Brockton. I hope you appreciate your community. Feliz Navidad, Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Thanks to all my staff and crew.
Thank you. Good job, everybody.
Listen, enjoy Brockton all the participants. In holiday time. And happy birthday, Mr. Edgar.